Hi, today we are looking at Tommy Emmanuel's traveling gloves. This is a sort of boomchick song, although quite often the boomchick is not muted. So could you call it boomchick anyway? Not sure. Anyway, it incorporates a lot of this pattern, but not always muted. You need your capo on the third fret. And that's all, as long as the introduction goes. Let's get closer. The intro seems rather easy because you just switch between those two shapes. Here you do this mini barra, and here you use your third and fourth. Once you have to go here to the... which fret is it? It's fifth and sixth. And bend it a little. But the rhythm is not that obvious. So, with your thumb, which plays on the open third string, you heard that? There is this little like double bass. Here, so. Through the open D to G. Okay, and then you go to this, it's also an intro, but the second part, where you switch between G and A E minor. So. So your thumb goes. So again, I can play it very slowly for you, but you will have to figure out what the actual rhythm is. And from this we go to the melody. Again, G, hammer on the second string with your pinky. So again, from G to E minor. Here it goes. And every time you go here, you don't play just, but instead you play. So you add this second fret. So. G in the bass. Again. So you go through this twice. Okay, and later you will also play it like. So here this note is much more pronounced. So. This point you go hammer on, and this I guess is A with C sharp in the bass. Okay, so the melody is open second string, then this and pull off. So, hammer on with your thumb. Here we have the second time round, we have F in the bass, so first time was and second time it is. And also the melody goes sort of in between the boom cheeks. Probably will be pretty hard. It's a sharp or B flat, whatever you like, major. But there will be meddling with the first string, first fret open. So if and you have to put your thumb on the fifth string here. So if your hand isn't that big, you can try to experiment with something like that. So you will have to raise your bara. But if you can do it that way. Because we have a little pull-off here. So... repeat all the thing. But the second time you can add a little bit of boom chick here. So just in the beginning of this repeat, and not anymore. So after playing it two times, again you land with this, and then we go into the chords, which again utilizes this shape, and you the melody goes. So it's double stops. So it's. So. And the boom chick goes. Then A minor. And the melody goes. Mini bar here. And again, if you can't grab this chord, you could try something, but then you can't have this movement. You will just have. Okay? But if that's the only reason why you couldn't play the song, I think it's worth to compromise. So A minor, and then from the F to G slide, little strums with again from F to G, only in different shape. So, and here, as you return to this shape, you just strum open strings for just a second. So, and you return to this. Go to this. It's D of some sort. D7, I think. And from this point, melody will go. Okay. Oh come on. Here. I have to go to this shape from somewhere else. Simple. D. So hammer on, pull off. So. So again from. This is probably the most important part of the song, so we have to go a little bit louder here as you approach this. So you strum and then go all the notes and you land on the G. So you return to the main theme. You play all of this twice, and at the end you go at the total end. So when you go from the main theme to the ending, you go. You go. Oh, here it is. So it's. You know this. But then. Instead of going, you go. So you stretch it in time. So it's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Sorry, yeah. 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Thanks for watching. Hope you will do well with the